We've got a controversial topic for you today. We're going to look at these insulation piercing connectors when connecting an additional consumer unit to existing meter tails. I've been asked to look at these by a number of EV installers. Now you can see the attraction of these because they actually make connecting an additional set of meter tails to the existing ones incredibly simple, because this little connector just wraps around the meter tail, clamps through, makes a connection, then you can tap off with these new tails. So just a little bit of background about these. These are a well-established technology. They even have their own standard, but you usually find them in what's called an ABC, or an aerial bundled cable. Now let's just see where you'd see these. Normally at the top of electricity poles, particularly in rural areas where they're distributing power overhead. And just have a closer look at an application used to tap into the bundled cable, possibly then to feed down into a property or tap off for something like a street light. Closer look at a bundled cable. So yeah, it's basically individual cables are wrapped around each other. They can be obviously insulated with an additional protective sheath on the outer. They can be aluminium or copper, and they do have their own extensive set of standards and are well established and are used extensively in that industry. So are they suitable for use indoors to connect the scenario we've got here? We'll just have a little closer look at what I've mocked up behind us. So here's typically what you see in a lot of EV charger installations. You've got an existing consumer unit that maybe has no spare capacity. It may have type AC RCD, so not suitable for connection of a new circuit to it, especially one feeding a charge point. So what a lot of installers do is we'll fit an additional smaller consumer unit. So here's a typical one you'd see with a circuit for a EV charger, possibly even a PME monitoring device in there, and then we've got our new tails, and then we somehow need to connect them into an existing set of meter tails or split the tails. And what we've done here is we've tested out these insulation piercing connectors, sometimes referred to as line taps. And yeah, they are incredibly easy. We'll show you how they fit in a moment. Before we do that, this is not eFIXX saying these are fantastic, crack on, use them. So just a word from our legal advisor, Mr. Joe Robinson.
Good evening, Solicitor Joe here. My clients at eFIXX have just asked me to confirm that the following information neither implies approval of nor condones the use of any product that may feature in said segment. All electricians will bear the individual responsibility for the installation of any accessories featured, and indeed any harm caused by such. Thank you.
So just to reiterate, we don't want to see pictures of this type of installation on Instagram, LinkedIn, with a, yeah, eFIXX, these are fantastic. Thanks for giving the seal of approval on them. This is just a discussion to get your opinion, because this is an area that we think is ripe for innovation. When you think about the number of EV charge points that are going to be installed over the coming years, what is the alternative? Well, obviously, the alternative is those trusty Henley blocks that we see in so many installations, but they take up a lot of room. They really haven't changed in, getting on for 100 years possibly. So not a good solution. So in theory, these could be a great solution. They are incredibly robust. This cable joined onto there is certainly not going anywhere. What's your thoughts on using these in this type of installation? So let's have a look at how you connect one of these insulation piercing connectors. I'm going to put the main meter tail through here, and then we're going to tap off with a branch connector here. So this will take up the 50 millimeter squared. This terminal here will take up to 10 millimeter squared. You notice it's got a waterproof compound in there, because normally this lives outdoors. And then we've got the shear bolt on the back. So I've connected up to the metrel, so we'll see when it makes contact. So I'm just going to spin that around there, bring in the branch conductor, push that through and in. You can hear the paste squeeze out. And then I'm going to bring in our meter tail just loosen this off a little bit and drop that in. Tighten it down by hand, and then we're going to start the tightening process. So you do need an incredible amount of torque to do this. So I'm just going to use those grips on that side and bring in the wrench. There are proper tools available for this, but it's just the first time we've done this. So you can see on the Metrel there, we've got obviously high resistance joint at the moment. We'll see when this starts to pierce into the connector. See, it's already in there, so low resistance, and then we've still got quite a way to shear this off. Keep tightening. And there we go, that bolt sheared off. So interesting, this bolt is not connected to actually the conductor, so we'll just push the put the continuity tester on again. See, we've got a low joint, low resistance joint. If we put it on the bolt, the bolt's not connected to the connector. Great piece of engineering, this. Here's one I destroyed earlier. You'll see if I undo this, how it's actually made up. So it's interesting, before you make the contact, you can't actually see any of the piercing conductors. But you peel this away, and there's what's been driven into the copper cable. So you've got those spikes there and shrouded by this. So it's IP2X when it's in its open state, IP4X when it's closed. No word on the waterproofing on that. Just have a look at a cable I used earlier as well. You can see in a previous attempt where the conductor bit in there. Wow, so they are incredibly easy to use, certainly a lot easier than having to tap in and cut the existing tails, put the Henley block in then, and then try and get everything back in the space you've got, provided a nice compact connection. However, a few things obviously concern us when we look at them. So think about these. They are, as the name said, aerial bundle connectors. So these normally go out of reach, high up where nobody can touch them. And that possibly brings the first thing that concerns us is when you look at this branch connector here, there is only the single layer of insulation preventing you getting to touch that conductor in there. So how durable is that? And then on some of the larger ones, we've seen that can actually be what looks like a twist-on cap. So somebody could very easily remove that without the use of tools. So put your opinion on what you think of that. And we also think there has probably not been a lot of tests done on PVC insulated tails with an outer sheath that we typically find in a UK installation. A lot of the tests are done on those aerial bundle conductors, which often have XLPE insulation and a very thin outer protective sheath as well. So what difference does that make? As you'll see in there, those little connection areas are pretty pointy and quite small when you consider actually the size of the cables we're using here. But we're already seeing some pictures of these installed on things like Instagram, and we have myth and legend behind it. People have seen manufacturers test data to show that somehow that's acceptable. We've also heard tales that DNOs are refusing to connect installations where they see these, and a cursory discussion with NIC, EIC inspectors, somebody mentioned that they'd suggest you'd have to put them in an additional enclosure, which would probably echo what we said about that cable connection there. But what do you think? Is this a great solution if a manufacturer is willing to go out there and do all the tests to validate performance, put some sort of safety approval on it? Could it speed up the installation of EV charge points? And let's face it, we have to install a lot of them over the next few years. So this is an area that is crying out for innovation. But we want your comments. Put them below. What do you think of this approach? Is this something you're using now? Have you seen people using this? Or is this something that basically is, nice to know, but We'll wait for someone to do the proper validation work. So put your comments below, and we'll see you on the next EV charging installation video.